fully see this body. And luckily I found one where she's wearing a onesie, because you can only imagine what's underneath it, how it would look. And I know that she thinks, like, I know, like, Gaga's got the big glasses in right now, and that's pretty cool, but, like, these look pretty cheap, and I don't know who she's trying to impress or fool. Like, she looks pretty ridiculous, so I don't think she's really pulling it off.
Is that the same picture?
I have the same picture.
Okay.
I see a lot of unhappy faces in the circle.
She looks really confused. She's like, what's going on here?
How did that make you
feel? I want to know what you're thinking right now.
Yeah. How did that make you feel?
Use the mic.
What?
Yeah, give her the mic.
She's a baby. She's cute. What are you talking about? Looks. It's wrong, right? Did it seem inappropriate?
Yeah.
Was it perhaps even violent?
Yes.
Totally not okay, right?
No.
So if it's not okay for me to say this to this beautiful 3-year-old girl, how come it's okay for us to say those exact same kind of things to ourselves when we look?
Because it's easier to comment or find negative things about yourself than to find positive things about yourself.
Sure.
Sure. But what's easier is not always what is right.
Yeah.
So I use this exercise because it's very unsettling, and it kind of gets to the point. In a very abrupt way, that there is a 3-year-old inside all of us, and the things that we say to our grown-up self are just as violent and just as hurtful and just as terrible as the things that we would say to our 3-year-old self. So if you look in the mirror, if you even are wherever you are and you're hearing those words, you're hearing that negative stinking thinking, I call it, ask yourself, hold on, would I say this to my 3-year-old self? And if you wouldn't, stop it, because you haven't developed some special sneaky metal exterior that keeps you right. You're just as sensitive. So if you can, if you need to, you can put a picture of your 3-year-old self up wherever it you might come across it, just to remind yourself. But if you can just envision that in your head, I think that's an important tool.